Supreme Court declared segregation in public schools unconstitutional in 1954. Southern resistance to the court's decision came to a head 3 years later in Little Rock, Arkansas, when a 15-year-old girl, Carlotta Walls, tried to go to school. The following explores the perceptions and experiences of that 15-year-old. From Martin Duberman's In White America. The night before, I was so excited I couldn't sleep. The next morning, I was about to bust one up. While I was pressing my black and white dress, I planned to go to my first day of school. A little brother turned on the TV set. They started talking about a large crowd gathered at surgery. The man on TV, he wondered if we were going to be there that morning. Then my mother called from the kitchen where she was fixing breakfast. Turn that TV off! She was so upset and worried. I wanted to come to her, so I said, "Mother, don't worry." Before I left for school, mother called us into the living room. She said we should have a word of prayer. Then I got on the bus and got off a block away from Central. There was a large crowd right across the street from the Soldiers' Guard in Central. As I walked on, all I could hear was the shuffling of their feet. Then they started following me, calling me names. I wasn't scared, just a bit nervous. Then my knees began to shake, and I wondered if I could make it to Central a block away. It was the longest block I'd ever make in my whole life. When I got to Central, I went up to a guard. He just looked straight ahead and didn't let me pass. Then I looked at the school. It looked so big. Just then, God let a few white students go past. When I was able to straighten up my knees, I went into the guard and let the white students go through. He too didn't move. When I tried to squeeze past him, he raised his bayonets, and then the other ones raised theirs. All I could hear from the crowd was, "No niggers gonna get in our school. Get out of here." Just then, I looked back down the block and saw a bench at the bus stop. I said to myself, if only I could make it there, I'll be safe. I don't know why the bench seemed like a safe place to me, but I started walking. I tried to ignore all the names they were calling me. When I sat down, I don't think I could have gone another step. Then the crowd came, started calling me names all over again. Just then, a white man sat down beside me, put his arm around me, and put his hand on my shoulder. "Thank you,"